Hi guys, today we will take a deeper look at kernel tone mapping inside kernel frame buffer, one of the new features of Chaos Kernel 8. If you haven't seen this yet, watch my video where I go through all the new features of kernel 8. Now let's jump to 3ds Max. I will be using the bar scene from our advanced interiors training. In case you want to check it out, I put the link to the course in the corner and in the description below the video. Let's open the tone mapping rollout and see what we have there. So you can see that it looks different now. Let's analyze it. First, we can notice some basic stackable operators that weren't in kernel previously. Simple exposure was called exposure before. We can adjust the values of each of the operators. We can also turn on and off the effect, exactly as it was previously. Also, the new operators can be added by clicking on the plus icon. Some operators from the list were previously supported, but also some new ones are introduced as well. We can choose vignette, for example, and adjust the effect. We can add some adjustments more than once. We can choose simple exposure, for instance. What is more, the operators can be moved higher or lower by dragging and placing them. The blue line indicates where an operator will be placed. We can also easily delete the effects by right-clicking on them and selecting delete. Okay, now let's reset everything and let's analyze what operators we have and what effects we can achieve with them. Let's start by testing the basic operators. Okay, as I have all of the basic operators added, let's analyze each of them. So simple exposure simply changes the overall exposure of the image. As it was in the previous versions of the kernel, white balance sets the white balance point using Kelvin temperature. With the green magenta tint, we can decide if we want to have a more magenta looking image or with a more greenish tint. The larger the value of the contrast, the more contrast the image we will get. We can also control the general saturation of the image by changing the value. A negative value means a less saturated image. We can add the vignetting effect as well. The larger the value, the stronger the effect. Photographic exposure instead changes the overall exposure of the image based on the settings of the currently used camera. So here, we don't change any value, it's automatically taken from the camera settings. And finally, we can set the overall color tint of the image. We can choose any color we like, and the entire picture will be multiplied by this color. We can create many effects here. Now let's see what else we have here. We can choose filmic mapping, which was in kernel before, just with different naming. So highlight compression is the same as what filming highlights in the previous versions, and it applies the effect to bright regions of the image. While filming shadows are now named rich shadows, and it applies the effect to dark regions of the image. We can also add curves in the same way as before. Tone curve is a new option, and it works as if you're editing the raw photo. It lets you to control different tones of the image. So with highlights, you can adjust the brightest areas of the image. Lights gives you the opportunity to adjust the lights, so the bright regions of the picture. Darks allows you to adjust the dark areas of the image. And with shadows, as the name says, we can adjust the shadows in the image, so the darkest regions. So you can see, there is lots of control with this operator. It's really cool to have it here now. Also, we have advanced filming that applies highlight compression and shadow saturation control using filming S-curve. It gives us more control in comparison to basic filming operator. We can change it with 5 parameters that allows us to adjust the effect in different segments of the S-curve, adjusting its dynamic range and stepness of the shoulder. The Reinhardt highlight compression option is equivalent to previous highlight compression, and it reduces or completely removes the burnout areas of the image. From the new options, we also have ACS output transform, so Academy Color Encoding System, which is basically a more sophisticated display transform. As you can read on the Corona blog, with this operator you can generally get greater adjustments of highlights and color saturation, resulting in a very filmic or photographic result. And finally, we can add the LUTs. So you can see that now we have much more control than before. We can make much more with post-production in VFB, which is always appreciated, don't you think? Also, we have some presets available. So basically, we have different presets of the operators from the tone mapping to choose from, and we can use them as a base for our images. We can edit the presets. We can switch off options we don't want to have, and we can change the values of different operators. It all depends on what effect we want to achieve. It would be nice to be able to save my own presets here. I think it's not possible except to save it here. If you know a way to do this, let me know in the comments. I like this update. It's a step in good direction. I wish we have a support for CryptoMate in VFB as well. Anyway, if you would like to learn how to create outstanding, advanced interior visualizations, I'd like to invite you to check out our advanced interiors training. Click here to check it out on our website. Bye bye!